Hi there, I'm Laura. I work in West Highland region in a place called Kinlochleven, and I'm going to be doing Children's Chapel with you today. First of all, what we need to do is light our Children's Chapel candle, and of course that reminds us that God is with us. So we'll get that done first. Super, I'll just pop that there. Now, as we get ready to pray, sometimes we're a little bit fidgety, so what we need to do is calm ourselves, and we are going to listen to a little note that I'm going to play on this guitar. As I play the note, I'll have my hand out like this, and as the note fades, I'll lower my hand really slowly, and then by the end, we'll be ready to pray. Let's go. Listen carefully. Fantastic. So, hands together, let's say our prayer. Dear Jesus, help us to be kind, especially during Lent as we get ready for Easter. Show us how we can follow the example of Mary and love you without limits, that by our behaviour we can be shining lights of your love in a dark world. Amen. There we go. Now it's going to be time for our story. And this week our story comes from John, and it teaches us about showing our love for God. It's called Jesus with Friends in Bethany. 6 days before the Passover feast, Jesus went to Bethany where Lazarus lived. Lazarus is the man Jesus raised from death. There they had a dinner for Jesus. Martha served the food. Lazarus was one of the people eating with Jesus. Mary brought in a pint of very expensive perfume made from pure nard. She poured the perfume on Jesus' feet. Then she wiped his feet with her hair. And the sweet smell of the perfume filled the whole house. Judas Iscariot, one of Jesus' followers, was there. He was the one who would later turn against Jesus. Judas said, "This perfume was worth an entire year's wages. It should have been sold and the money given to the poor." But Judas did not really care about the poor. He said this because he was a thief. He was the one who kept the money box, and he often stole money from it. Jesus answered, "Let her alone. It was right for her to save this perfume for today, the day for me to be prepared for burial. The poor will always be with you, but you will not always have me." There we go. So Jesus in this story, he had walked a long way with his friends along dusty roads. So I'm sure all their feet needed a good wash. But it's not expected that when you go to somebody's house for dinner, they wash your feet. It was really unusual. But Mary was grateful to Jesus for bringing her brother Lazarus back from the dead. I wonder, though, why she used her hair like a towel to clean Jesus' feet, and why she used the expensive perfume oil. Do you think Mary was showing her love for Jesus? Why, then, did Judas, who was one of Jesus' closest friends, tell her off for doing that? Do you think he was really worried about the cost of the oil? Well, even though Judas told everybody he was friends with Jesus, he wasn't an honest person, and he would soon betray Jesus by telling the soldiers where he was so Jesus would be arrested. I think we need to make sure that what we say matches what we do, and that if we say we love Jesus, then we follow his commandments and we say sorry when we get things wrong. So now it's time to do our little activity. And for this week's activity, all we need is a piece of paper, some scissors and a pencil, and some colouring pencils, pens or crayons, whatever you've got at home. So we start off and we take our piece of paper and we fold it in half, you see, like this. And we take our hand and we put the thumb next to the fold of the piece of paper, just like this, and all the fingers beside it. Now here's where you might need some help. So you take your pencil and you draw around the shape of your hand onto the paper, nice and slowly, taking care not to move your hand. And then try and lift your arm and get underneath as well till you've got the hand shape. And of course then you take your scissors and you carefully cut it out, or get a big brother or sister or a grown-up to help you. So what you're left with is something like this. You see, that's my hand shape, and it's like a wee book where the thumbs are stuck together. Now what I thought we could do with this is inside we could draw pictures of or write all the things that you're thankful for. So in my one, I've drawn my friends, I've drawn the flowers and the insects, I've drawn music, and I've drawn a cat. But you can draw anything you like, anything that you're thankful for. Because prayers come in three main groups. Sometimes we might need help with something. Maybe we're worried and we can ask God to help us to be brave. Other times we might need to say sorry for something that we have done wrong. Maybe we've been unkind to somebody or not listened to our parents. And the other important prayers are thank you prayers, where we talk to God and tell him all the things that we love. So once you've finished your prayer hands and you've got all your things that you're thankful for inside, you can share them with us. You can share a picture or a video as a comment on the Facebook page, or you can submit them to the Dropbox folder using the link on the screen. Now it's time for us to close this worship by praying the words that Jesus taught us. So take a moment to prepare your hearts for God as we get ready to pray the Lord's Prayer.
Ar nahar aha neve, gunuichar denyum, hikuk do riach, jiener do hul erantalo, mar nir neve, tavar gain in ju ar narin lyle, agus magaina ar fiachin, avol avai hishinya daluch fiach, agus na lake shin and burushin, achsur shina alk, or slatsa and riach, agus and kuach, agus and glor, hushiri. Amen.
It's been so lovely to spend this time with you in Children's Chapel. I hope you have a lovely week, and I hope to see you again soon. So one more thing to do before we go is we need to blow out our Children's Chapel candle, just like this. But remember, just because the Children's Chapel candle is blown out and the light has gone away, it doesn't mean that God has gone away, because God is always with us. So let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.